There's bank protection, goes all the way up and down the river on both sides of the river. Here's a barge with some rocks on it and a bulldozer that dumps the rocks in laterally in a line crossways of the river to slow the current down. The more imperfect it is, the better it is for fish and fishermen. After it's finished, they take an empty barge and just plow it down and level it off about 4 to 6 feet underneath the surface, how deep the barge sits in the water. And when it's finished, this is what it looks like. This wing dam right here has a couple holes in it, and the current's a little bit stronger in those holes, and that'll affect it later when with siltation. And fish like those holes and up the ends of it because the current's a little stronger, or there's eddies. Be careful of the buoy markers out in the middle of the river. A lot of times they drop those buoys off the end of the wing dams, and that can ends of those wing dams can be really shallow if they miss it when they level it off. They like to mark them so the barges don't hit them themselves, don't hit the wing dams. Here, before they build the wing dam, the different depths of the water, how it gradually drops off. And here's what the wing dam looks like when it's finished from up above. Notice where it's deeper, it's bigger round. There's these big mounds out there, and they get all the bigger with siltation from the current washing through and the eddies that they cause. And the holes are, the current's a little bit stronger, so it makes little ditches, as you can see right here in this illustration. Usually those ditches are the best places for to hold fish. And here's an old river bank. Sometimes the bank protection doesn't work so good, and it erodes away, and put a new one up, and that leaves an old line of rocks up and down the river.